intelligence also. The only caveat is the name of the notice or the law, it may change, right? But talking in terms of India, it's the CRPC 91 notice. And this topic won't even end over here. Ahead, you know, ahead in some modules, such as, you know, banking, investigation, fraud and all, how do the law enforcement agencies do that? At that time, you know, in a very, you know, I think around third last or the second last modules, again, this CRPC will come into action. Okay, yes. CRPC 91. Today, it will be a brief about it. Like, you know, a generalized idea about the CRPC 91 notice. Okay, so let me just start sharing the screen. Going to Edmodo. Let me know if the screen is not visible. So there is a PDF also, and there is a link, reference link also that has been provided. I'll just open both. This is the this is known as the constitutional validity of CRPC 91, right? And it's all about, you know, historical background and the law. So I won't be going through this link. It's a self-read. It's a reference material, right? And I'm not sure about others, but Sam sir, they don't want me to cover laws. it's boring, right? So we'll go through this. Just a minute. Okay. Yeah, sorry. And sir, I'm the same. I also don't like to learn about laws much. No worries. Okay. Now, CRPC 91 notice. Okay. What it is all about? It's all about getting information from, I mean, getting information. The method that COOPS uses to get information. Okay. This is notice. I mean, if I just talk about CRPC, you can say, and basically an act. If I just, you know, open the reference once again. The Code of Criminal Procedure. Okay. Code of Criminal Procedure, CRPC 91 notice. So section 91 of Code of Criminal Procedure, that's why it is known as CRPC 91. What exactly it is? So CRPC 91, it summons to produce document or other thing whenever any court or any officer is in charge of a police station considers that the production of any document or other thing is necessary or desirable for the purposes of any investigation, inquiry, trial or other proceedings under this code, or by before such court or officer, such court may issue a summons or such officer, a police officer, a written order to the person whose possession or power to such document or thing is believed to be requiring to attend or produce it, or to produce it at the time and the place stated in the summons or the order. Don't ignore this, you know, technical terms. I'll just explain what it is. Any person requiring under this section merely to produce a document or other thing shall be deemed to have a complied with the requisition if he causes such document or thing to be produced instead of attending personally to produce the same. In short, the provision gives the powers to a court or a police officer only in charge of a police station to ask for the production of any document for the purpose of investigation. It's not something that we all investigators or PI can do. Only, you know, it is only, you know, in terms of law enforcement agencies only. Now see, now let us this part over here, what it is all about. Now let us examine the powers or the lack of it of an officer in charge of a police station under this section in the case of online content. Deletion or blocking of content. This provision only enables the police officer to conduct an investigation and can by no stretch of imagination be used as a censorship to delete or block the content. This cannot be done. But this is something as PI we can interfere. We are going to learn about it under the DMCA law, right? DMCA privacy notice. Now, even in the case of books, copyrights, even in case of books or newspapers or other documents, the state government will have to notify an order for filling such books or newspaper, and only based on such order, a police officer can seize such publications. Yeah, the Code of Criminal Procedure. As per the Section 95 of the CRPC. This cannot be done under Section 95 of the CRPC. This the means by which a direction can be issued to block a consent is under Section 69A of the IT Act 2000 and not under CRPC. Okay. Then, demanding information from the accused. Article 23 of the Constitution of India provides citizen to right against self-incrimination or right against testimony. Just a minute. Just hold a minute. Demanding information from the accused, the Article 23 of the Constitution of India provides citizens the right against self-incrimination or right against testimony that would be discussed, that would be against his interest in a case, right? So, an example of it would be the Honorable Supreme Court as held in the state of Gujarat versus Shyam Choksi case, that the Section 94 of the CRPC on its true construction does not apply to an accused person. The CRPC 91 notice cannot be used by the police for asking information from an accused in an online defamation case. But this kind of interviewing and interrogation can, to some extent, can be done by PIs, right? Now, in short, what it is all about, let me just explain in simple terms. In a very layman term, I am explaining this CRPC 91 notice is nothing but it's a notice to fetch information. This can be initiated by law enforcement only, or you can say police only. Okay, PI has no power to create it. Now, these can be used in various set of cases. Getting Facebook details. You remember when someone asks you, how does the police solve a case? We always say they will, just get the IP details from the ISP and all those other things, right? How do they do that? How the ISP will share the detail? Getting details from the IR, details from ISP, Internet Service Provider. This is also under CRPC 91. They'll send a CRPC 91 notice. Getting details from social media platforms. Social media / OTT, whatever. Any online platform. And why in terms of financial fraud only police can act? Because they only have the power to initiate, a CRPC notice to get account details from You know, for the regarding of the mails as soon as possible. Details of the login and logout. What are the details that I've asked? See, what are the details that police have asked to provide? Details of login and logout with respective IP address, date and time, from date to the creation of account till date. So many logs. Personal details of user provided by him or her at the time of creation. Phone number used.
हाँ हाँ भाई हेलो। हाँ, तू ही तो है अर्षद। और कौन है अर्षद? बोल बोल। नहीं लगाया था ना? क्या वन नहीं लगाना था क्या? अरे रोज आते हैं यार। बोल। हेलो हेलो। आवाज नहीं आ रही भाई।
We see 91 notices we are going to go throughout this entire course. As and on we'll move on in the modules. So till now, will you share this docs as well? Need to confirm, sir, once from the management. Okay, and even if I'll share, I'll just white out everything and just keep the main stuff. Is it okay?
Yeah, then I'll share.
Then I'll share. Still, let me just get it confirmed from the management. So, any doubts till now? Anyone?
Is the second page mandatory for every notice?
In most of the cases, yes. Now,
क्या मतलब?
I want you people
क्या मतलब मतलब?
To get on some case examples. So, now you remember we had discussed a case study about a
क्या मतलब?
Murder of a doctor.
Nice.
Remember that?
जैसा बताओ दीदी।
Yes. So how did the law enforcement agencies took the logs from the search engine provider? Using CRPC 91. Right. Now let us discuss a few things.
अच्छा क्या हो गया?
दिस इज नॉट ऑल द यू नो स्टैटिक स्ट्रक्चर दैट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग ग्राफ आइडिया ओके डोंट कंसीडर इट इज द ओनली सिंगुलर स्ट्रक्चर ओके द हेड स्ट्रक्चर हाउ व्हाट इज द देयर इन द मेन हेड देन दिस स्टेटमेंट यू नो इफ यू सी right this will be there then it will be there it's just like a official letter right you can say or even before subject I'm sorry before subject party from which or you can just say the body from which
नहीं अभी मैं क्या कहते हैं जून में करूंगा
इन्फो इज टू बी कलेक्टेड लाइक द सीटीओ और हूसोएवर इन चार्ज आईएसपी देयर विल बी द सब्जेक्ट वन लाइनर फॉर द इन्फो नीडेड दिस विल बी द सब्जेक्ट
लिखते हैं यार
Yeah, yeah, sir. That was that is what I am going to do actually. I mean, before that, I also am not liable to provide anything. That will be done for sure. Then only I can share.
Bolo, sir. Bolo.
Because this is something of the extreme confidentiality, right? Yes. So subject will be there. Then there will be you can say the officer in charge whose name and it will be there that the officer in charge is asking of dash 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 police station okay under a case registered you can just say in that term with you know so and with so and so charges applied to that and there is an offense that a case is filed for you know this you know victim whatever bullying on Instagram example I'm just saying okay or okay just say let's consider the example for you know this reasons and provide information needed list of information needed okay why my keyboard is troubling me today I don't know sorry the information that is needed then there will be this you know one liner saying that you know you are actually involved you know in the legal custodian so kindly send on the below email id details of police or details of enforcement where they need the you know email or somewhere or in some cases you know they are just trying to dial up you know the phone number of the officer is present in charge right personal phone number landline number right so that details and the second page will be about CRPC 91 as a law this will be the structure of the CRPC 91 notice I don't know how it will be shared on Skype, but I hope it's structured. You can just. Okay. क्रिमिनल कन्विक्शन. व्हाट एग्जैक्टली सर डू यू आर ट्राइंग टू से अबाउट, आई मीन व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आर ट्राइंग टू रेफर व्हाइल सेइंग क्रिमिनल कन्विक्शन? This CRPC 91 notice, it is an official power with a law enforcement agency. I mean, to be very honest, why I'm saying no to share these documents? They are actual documents. They are actual CRPC 91 notices. Okay. It's an official power with the law enforcement officer. It's not an assumption. Right. Now, let's discuss one or two examples, quick, very quick. Assume that you want to produce a CRPC 91 notice. XYZ cyber wing. Okay, whatever. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy the same things from above. I'll just, you know, change a few things and small question. I mean, just discussing in terms of, you know, just to, you know, get the things better and make you think in terms of CRPC a bit. And then I want from CTO. Instagram. Okay, for you can say a case is filed for victim facing my keyboard, some keys are stopped working, I don't know why. Maybe because my PC right now is a barbecue. I'm getting fried. Yeah, Instagram. Now you all tell me, if this is a CRPC, what all information according to you is needed to get the leads? Insta, okay, so wait. Insta ID will be provided by police. URL and Insta ID will be provided by police, right? That things that on, you know, we want info of that only. What information will police need? Like, what information the police must ask to this technical officer of Instagram? What do you think? Exactly. So, IP address with, you know, MAC and, you know, zonal areas, which area that IP is belonging to, or even at times, you know, the location from where the IP is accessed. Or any other IP used. Maybe there could be a different device which could have a different IP, right? Okay. To access the accounts. Even before that, login info. Right? Since the account start until date. Right. then yes, it could be followers and following info. Right. And I think Khiladi sir have mentioned more points. Yeah, then login, log out. Yeah, Mac details. I just, yeah, IP address with Mac. I've added any more. Exactly. That was what I was looking for. Email address / secondary email address and recovery email address. Mobile phone or mobile number, I mean, associated recovery mobile number. And that dates will be there in login info, right? The dates will be mentioned in the login info, the login logs. Any more points? Exif data from post. Exactly. Because I'm talking about the platform Instagram, right? So there could be a possibility that the cops will ask about the exif details of Insta posts. Right? Because Instagram, I mean, that depends. Why? Because Instagram and these platforms, they strip the exif data, right? But still they can provide. They strip out the exif data. Anything else? Metadata of what, sir? Yeah, metadata of the images is equals to exif data. Post like by users, and that would be in some, you know, rare cases, but the main sensitive info is this, right? And then at the end they'll mention any other important info that will help us to solve the case. Officer in charge, yours faithfully, and you know all those terms. Then, I think for Instagram is this much. You can, you know, similarly, you know, pile up and understand for other case studies also if you want. Right? We anyways are going to see other notices also. More like this in the, you know, upcoming classes. Sir, depends on police station to police station, but there is no centralized channel, okay? Yeah, that's the truth. There is no centralized standard operating procedure, or there is no centralized rules for doing so. Yeah. Generally, while making the notice, they only, it's done to the high-end authority officers. So they do take care of these kind of things. You know, sharing with that particular email that no one has access to. Yeah. Yes, passport protection of the documents will be done. And whenever that particular vendor will send the info, that document also will be, you know, protected. Yeah, I mean, not most, sir. All CRPC docs will be signed with police stamp and all, compulsorily. I have just, you know, whited out those things over here. So that's all there for today's class. Anyone, any doubts? Anyone? Any doubts? AG, all good. AG, all clear? Not so far. Cool. Okay. I can see Sam sir and Clary sir typing something, so I'll just wait. Yes, sir. Let me just do the alterations. And also let me just once confirm with the management. See, Sam sir, this actually things are taken up not by, you know, low level persons. They are actually taken by, you know, at least a superior rank officer. Okay. So they do have a maintained criminal record for it, and you know, the case record, the file of the case, in that these things will be noted out, they will be logged. Khiladi sir, I guess only DCP is not responsible. In some cases, PI are also being seen in the notices. SPs, superintendents. Impersonation, sir. We are running about cyber crime and you are talking about crime as of now. It's a crime itself. This is a gold. I mean, sir, see this info. I mean, it's not something that, you know, I've just taken up randomly. Me and my senior, you know, we were there in together working, mainly my senior who is there, you know, mainly my senior who is there on your investigator. We were actually involved in crime investigation. I mean, mainly they were involved. The senior, he was involved with cops and all. So from there, we have got a bit of help. This is more like just emails. Not like that. But yeah, the verification is done, sir. Like, you know, they provide mobile numbers and also. At times, the providers of the information, they verify it with the cops first before providing it. That's the reason, you know, the mobile number and everything is attached. Mm-hmm. I mean, if I just talk about other countries, see, I'm not sure what is the criminal law over there, but the similar kind of notices, you know, they are produced to fetch the info. Yeah, sir, power to do, sir, now that depends on the police rank in India. You know, in India, there are a lot of ranks of police officers. Generally, the high post officers are responsible. In some cases, if a person who is in a cyber crime cell department and is technically very strong, that guy also has the authority to do so. It could be a superintendent of police. It could be the deputy commissioner. Yes. Right. It depends on how many, what stars the police officer is holding on the shoulder. Yeah, investigation don't have this power also, unfortunately. Okay, done. So then that's all for today, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this particular session. Tomorrow, there will be a test. Okay. What are the things in the test will be declared tomorrow morning or till tonight? No. Sir, don't worry. It won't be on laws. Laws test, we will have some, you know, on weekend or, you know, week, the coming week. Tomorrow is Friday, right? So Saturday, Sunday, you will have ample of time, you know, to refer to the previous docs. Tomorrow, we will have a small test. And then on Monday, we can have a big test. And then, you know, we can move on the practicals from the coming week. Okay. So be prepared. Everything, you know, will be shared. What to see, what not to see, what will be asked, what won't be asked. Yeah, so it will be on Edmodo. So be ready. Yes. Thank you, everyone. Sam sir, have a good day. Rest others, have a good night. Thank you.
तो फिर तो बहुत सही है।